Hello, my name is Dr. John Smelcer, and welcome to another episode of Ahtna 101. Before I start, I'd like to just remind the viewers that I am a member of the Ahtna tribe, that I'm a member of the traditional native village of Taslina, and that I was the executive director of our tribal heritage foundation for several years, in which time, besides other projects, I helped compile, edit, and publish a dictionary of our language in 1998, and have since revised it several times. I'd like this episode is words related to clothes or clothing. So first, just the word for clothes is you. Our word for dance clothes, because we do potlatching, which I'll talk about soon, but our dance clothes is das you. If you're from Mentasta, our northernmost village, it's kedzes. And kedzes has to do with the word like skin. So it's the skin you wear or the outer skin you wear. Clothes. Isn't that what clothes really are? A shirt or a dress in general is gaik. Gaik. If you're from Mentasta, it's a little bit different. Not much though. Dekaik. Dekaik. If you have your potlatch shirt, and remember, a potlatch is very important. It's a ceremony or ritual done in times of joy and increasingly in times of death and memoriam. And that is kutith gaig. Kutith gaig. You can hear the word gaig almost like gaik, but it's gaig. A skirt, like a woman would wear, is dabak. Dabak. A blouse that a woman would wear is kakiri. Kakiri. If you're from the upper village is up along the Copper River. They call it kazik. Kazik. A coat, like just put on your coat, it's cold out, is a Russian loan word. It's not a word that we originally had. It was beldi. Beldi. And the reason we didn't really have it is because we wore parkas. If you've ever seen a picture of what we'll call an Eskimo, though they don't call themselves that, you've seen a parka. It kind of flares at the bottom a little bit, like almost like a skirt or a dress. Well, parka is dandegaik, dandegaik. And you can hear the word gaik in there again, for kind of like a shirt. If you're from our lower village, it's gani gaik, gani gaik. A vest. Now, when you think vest, don't think of, you know, a modern-day businessman with a matching vest. These were leather vests that would have beading and fur, and we wear them especially at potlatches. And that is Dutch egelzoi. And finally, the word for blanket. Now, blanket is very important. It's very important not just to keep warm and cold Alaskan winter nights, but it's very central to our potlatching and the trade and the giving away of things. And so that's cheda, cheda. And if you're from our lower villages, way down the Copper River, it's seda. The same word is used for robe, because you could take a blanket and drape it over you to keep you warm. Well, that's it for this episode of Ahtna 101.